Do your feet look like this? If so, you're probably suffering from a fungal infection of the feet, commonly known as athlete's foot. In this video, I'll explain what athlete's foot is, the treatment options, and how to prevent it in the future. Did you know that approximately 1 in 4 people will experience athlete's foot at some stage in their life? The medical term for this condition is tinea pedis, and it's a fungal infection on the skin of the feet. Fungi thrive in warm, damp environments with minimal air exposure, making the feet an ideal location. If you're suffering from athlete's foot, you may have already noticed an intense itch, scaly or flaky skin on your feet, most commonly between the toes, and the skin itself can split, leaving painful cracks. Is it contagious? Yes, athlete's foot is contagious, and can quickly spread through direct contact with an infected person's foot or through exposure to the dry flakes of infected skin that have fallen away. The most common places to contract this condition are shared changing rooms and showers, where individuals tend to walk around barefoot. Unfortunately, because athlete's foot can spread by direct contact with an infected individual's skin, it's a good idea to take a break from playing footsie at night with your partner. What treatment is available? We need to treat athlete's foot as soon as it arises, because it can progress and even lead to fungal nail infections. Fortunately, most people can treat this effectively in the comfort of their own homes. Athlete's foot treatments are available over the counter in many different forms, including creams, sprays, and powders. For adults, it doesn't really matter which type you use, as long as it contains one of the following active ingredients: clotrimazole, miconazole, ketoconazole, econazole, terbinafine, undecanoic acid, or tolnaphdate. You should apply this antifungal treatment for as long as the manufacturer advises you to. Usually, you'll see an improvement in a matter of days, but it can come back. In some cases, you may need to continue to apply the cream for an additional 1 to 2 weeks to ensure that all the fungal elements are eradicated. If you're having trouble managing your athlete's foot, or if your infection is quite severe, or you have a history of diabetes or immunosuppression, it's advisable to seek early assessment from your doctor. In more challenging cases, your doctor may choose to take skin scrapings to confirm the diagnosis. We can prescribe potent oral antifungal medications, usually taken daily for a few weeks. Such antifungal treatments shouldn't be used without caution, as they can, in rare cases, cause liver injury. Therefore, it's likely you'll be asked to complete blood tests before starting treatment and a few weeks after to ensure the oral antifungal medications are safe for you. How can I prevent it again in the future? Taking certain precautions is essential to minimize the likelihood of developing fungal foot infections. Firstly, promptly treat any fungal infections that occur on your feet. Additionally, maintain clean and dry feet and wear fresh socks daily, and opt for shoes crafted from breathable materials. Always wear footwear in communal areas and changing rooms to reduce the risk of infection. When possible, try to allow your feet to breathe by taking off your shoes and socks at home. However, if you're currently infected, make sure that you're not putting others at risk. I hope you found this information helpful, and I wish you success in treating your athlete's foot. Bye bye.